The truth about Missy Elliott. Melissa Arnette Elliott, born July 1, 1971, is an American rapper, singer, songwriter and record producer. She embarked on her music career with R&B girl group Sista in the early mid-1990s and later became a member of the Swing Mob Collective along with childhood friend and longtime collaborator Timbaland, with whom she worked on projects for American R&B acts Aaliyah, 702, Total, and SWV. Following several collaborations and guest appearances, she launched her solo career on July 15, 1997 with her debut album Supa Dupa Fly, which spun the top 20 single Sock It To Me. The album debuted at number 3 on the Billboard 200, the highest charting debut for a female rapper at the time. Elliott's second album, Dario World, was released on June 22, 1999, and produced the singles She's a Bitch, All in My Grill, and top 5 hit Hot Boys. The remix of the latter song broke the record for most weeks at number 1 on the US R&B chart on the issue dated January 15, 2000, as well as spending 18 weeks at number 1 on the Hot Rap Singles chart, from December 4, 1999, to March 25, 2000. With the release of Missy So Addictive, 2001, Under Construction, 2002, and This Is Not a Test, 2003, Elliott established an international career that yielded hits including Get Her Freak On, One Minute Man, For My People, Gossip Folks, and Work It. The latter won her a Grammy Award for Best Female Rap Solo Performance. Elliott went on to win 4 Grammy Awards and sell over 30 million records in the United States. She is the best-selling female rapper in Nielsen music history, according to Billboard in 2017. In 2019, she released her first extended play, titled Iconology, became the first female rapper inducted into the Songwriters Hall of Fame and received the MTV VMA's Michael Jackson Video Vanguard Award for her impact on the music video landscape. In 2020, Billboard ranked her at number 5 on the 100 Greatest Music Video Artists of All Time. Life and Career, 1971-88. Early life, Melissa Arnette Elliott was born on July 1, 1971, at Portsmouth Naval Hospital in Portsmouth, Virginia. She is the only child of mother Patricia Elliott, a power company dispatcher, and father Ronnie, a former U.S. Marine. Elliott grew up in an active church choir family, and singing was a normal part of her youth. At the age of 4, she wanted to be a performer, and, as biographer Veronica A. Davis writes, she would sing and perform for her family. In later years, she feared no one would take her seriously, because she was always the class clown. While her father was an active Marine, the family lived in Jacksonville, North Carolina, in a manufactured home community. Elliott blossomed during this part of her life. She enjoyed school for the friendships that she formed even though she had little interest in schoolwork. She would later get well above average marks on intelligence tests, and she was advanced 2 years ahead of her former class. Her move in grades caused isolation, and she purposely failed, eventually returning to her previous class. When her father returned from the Marines, they moved back to Virginia, where they lived in extreme poverty. Life in Virginia saw many hardships. Elliott talks about domestic abuse by her father. She refused to stay over at friends' homes out of fear that on her return home she would find her mother dead. When Elliott was 8, she was molested by a cousin. In one violent incident, Ronnie Elliott dislocated his wife's shoulders and during another, Elliott herself was threatened with a gun. At the age of 14, Elliott's mother decided to end the situation and fled with her daughter on the pretext of taking a joyride on a local bus. In reality, the pair had found refuge at a family member's home where their possessions were stored in a loaded U-Haul truck. Elliott tells her that she feared her father would kill them both for leaving. She later stated, "When we left, my mother realized how strong she was on her own, and it made me strong. It took her leaving her home to be able to realize that." Elliott and her mother lived in the Hodges Ferry neighborhood of Portsmouth, Virginia. Elliott graduated from Manor High School in Portsmouth, Virginia, in 1990. 1991-95, Sista and Career Beginnings, two persons seated and one standing over a mixing board. At the far right is Timbaland, Elliott's childhood friend Timbaland, pictured in 2012. Far right, helped define her sound and the two have continued working together for decades. In 1991, Elliott formed an all-female R&B group, called Phase, later renamed Sista, with friends LaShawn Shellman, Chanita Coleman, and Radiah Scott. She recruited her neighborhood friend Timothy Mosley, Timbaland, as the group's producer and began making demo tracks, among them included the 1991 promo First Move. Later in 1991, Faze caught the attention of Jodeci member and producer Devani Swing by performing Jodeci songs a cappella for him backstage after one of his group's concerts. In short order, Faze moved to New York City and signed to Elektra Records through Devani Swing mob imprint and also renaming the group Sista. Sista's debut song was titled Brand New, which was released in 1993. Elliott took Mosley, whom Devaney rechristened Timbaland, and their friend Melvin Magoo Barcliffe along with her. 20 Albanian Lex plus members of the Swing Mob, among them future stars such as Genuine, Playa, and Tweet, lived in a single two-story house in New York and were often at work on material both for Giudici and their own projects. While Elliott wrote and rapped on Raven Simone's 1993 debut single, That's What Little Girls Are Made Of, she also contributed, credited and uncredited, to the Giudici album's Diary of Her Mad Band, 1993, and the show, The After Party, The Hotel, 1995. Timbaland and Devante jointly produced the Sista album, entitled For Albanian Lex The Sistas Around Bell World, 1994. Elliott met R&B artist Mary J. Blige while Blige was in sessions for her second album My Life. Though videos were released for the original and remix versions of the single Brand New, the album was shelved and never released. One of the group's tracks, It's Alright featuring Craig Mack, did however make the cut on the soundtrack of the 1995 motion picture Dangerous Minds, but by the end of 1995, Swing Mob had folded and many of its members dispersed. Elliott, Timbaland, Magoo, Genuine, and Playa remained together and collaborated on each other's records for the rest of the decade as the musical collective The Super Friends. 1996-98, Supa Dupa Fly, Aaliyah Smiling, Elliott began collaborating with other artists in the late 1990s, including Aaliyah, pictured in 2000. After leaving Swing Mob, Elliott and Timbaland worked together as a songwriting production team, crafting tracks for X including SWV, 702, and most notably Aaliyah. The pair wrote and produced 9 tracks for Aaliyah's second album, One in a Million, 1996, among them the hit singles If Your Girl Only Knew, One in a Million, Hot Like Fire, and Four Page Letter. Elliott contributed background vocals and or guest raps to nearly all of the tracks on which she and Timbaland worked. One in a Million went double platinum and made stars out of the production duo. Elliott and Timbaland continued to work together for other artists, later creating hits for artists such as Toto. What About Us? 1997, Nicole Ray. Make It Hot, 1998, and Destiny's Child. Get on the Bus, 1998, as well as one final hit for Aaliyah, I Care For You, before her death in 2001. Elliott also wrote the bulk of Total's second and final album Kima, Keisha, and Pam and Nicole Ray's debut Make It Hot, both released in 1998. Elliott began her career as a featured vocalist rapping on Sean Puffy Combs' Bad Boy remixes to Gina Thompson's The Things That You Do, which had a video featuring cameo appearances by Notorious B.I.G. and Puff Daddy, MC Light's 1996 hit single Cold Rock a Party, backup vocals by Gina Thompson, and New Edition's 1996 single You Don't Have to Worry. In 1996, Elliott also appeared on The Man of Visions remix of Do THANGZ, which was produced by Rodney Jerkins, coincidentally the producer of the original version of The Things That You Do. Combs had hoped to sign Elliott to his Bad Boy record label. Instead, she signed a deal in 1996 to create her own imprint, The Goldmind Incorporated, with East West Records, which at that time was a division of Elektra Entertainment Group, for which she would record as a solo artist. Timbaland was again recruited as her production partner, a role he would hold on most of Elliott's solo releases. Missy continued to work with other artists and appeared on LSG's song All the Time with Gerald Levert, Keith Sweat, Johnny Gill, Faith Evans, and Coco in 1997 on Levert Sweat Joe Classic album. The same year, she rapped in Keys to My House with old friends group Levert. In the center of a busy period of making guest appearances and writing for other artists, Elliott's debut album, Supa Dupa Fly, was released in mid-1997. The success of its lead single The Rain led the album to be certified platinum. The success was also a result of the music videos of her single releases, which were directed by Harold Hype Williams, who created many groundbreaking hip-hop, Afro-futuristic videos at the time. The album was nominated for Best Rap Album at the 1998 Grammy Awards, but lost to Puff Daddy's No Way Out. The year also saw Elliott perform live at the MTV Video Music Awards show on a remix to Lil' Kim's Ladies Night with fellow rappers Dabrat, Angie Martinez and TLC rapper Left Eye. Elliott continued her successful career in the background as a producer and writer on Total's single Trippin', as well as working with several others in the hip-hop and R&B communities. Elliott co-wrote and co-produced 2 tracks on Whitney Houston's 1998 album My Love Is Your Love, providing vocal cameos for In My Business and Oh Yes. Elliott also produced and made a guest appearance on Spice Girl Melanie Brown's debut solo single, I Want You Back, which topped the UK singles chart in Brown's native United Kingdom and is Elliott's only chart-topping song in that country. 1999 to 2001, Dario World and Missy So Addictive. Although a much darker album than her debut, Elliott's second album was just as successful as the first, selling 1.5 million copies and 3 million copies worldwide. She remarked, "I can't even explain the pressure. The last album took me a week to record. This one took almost 2 months. I couldn't rush it the second time because people expect more." Dario World, 1999, included the singles All In My Grill, a collaboration with Nicole Ray and Big Boy, from Outkast, a remix to Hot Boys and She's a Bitch. Also in 1999, Elliott was featured, alongside Dobrat, on the official remix to a Mariah Carey single Heartbreaker. A music video was filmed for the remix, shot in black and white and featuring a cameo appearance by Dog. The Desert Storm remix is acclaimed from music critics and became a cult remix. Missy Elliott next released Missy So Addictive on May 15, 2001. The album spun a massive pop and urban hits One Minute Man, featuring Ludacris and Trina, and Get Her a Freak On, as well as the international club hit For My People and the less commercially successful single Takeaway. The double music video for Takeaway / For My People was released in the fall of 2001, shortly after the sudden death of Elliott's close friend Aaliyah on August 25 and the 9/11 terrorist attacks. The Takeaway video contained images of and words about Aaliyah, and the slow ballad acted as a tribute to her memory. The remainder of the video was the more upbeat For My People, contained scenes of people dancing happily in front of American flags and Elliott dressed in red, white and blue. Though Takeaway was not a success on radio, For My People went on to become an American and European club hit due to a popular remix by house music duo Basement Jaxx in 2002. Tweet's appearance on Elliott's Takeaway as well as her cameo at Elliott's house on MTV Cribs helped to create a buzz about the new R&B singer. Tweet's own debut single, Oops, Oh My, was co-written by Elliott and released through Goldmind in February 2002. The single was a top 10 hit, thanks partially to Elliott's songwriting and guest rap, and to Timbaland's unusual production on the track. Elliott co-produced the Christina Aguilera, Lil Kim, Maya and Pink cover of Lady Marmalade for the album Moulin Rouge. Music from Baz Luhrmann's film, which went to number 1 on the Billboard Hot 100 in 2001. 2002-04, Under Construction and This Is Not a Test. For her next outing, Elliott and Timbaland focused on an old-school sound, utilizing many old-school rap and funk samples, such as Run DMC's Peter Piper and Frankie Smith's Double Dutch Bus. Elliott's fourth album, 2002's Under Construction, see 2002 in Music, is known as the best-selling female rap album with 2.1 million copies sold in the United States. In 2002, Elliott won a Grammy Award for Best Rap Solo Performance for Get Her a Freak On. In 2003, Under Construction received Grammy nominations for Best Rap Album and Album of the Year. The New York Times designated Under Construction this year's Best Hip Hop Album. Elliott released two singles off of Under Construction. The lead single, Work It, reached number 2 on Billboard's Hot 100 chart and won the Video of the Year award at MTV's Video Music Awards. The second single, Gossip Folks featuring Ludacris, became a top 10 hit on Billboard's Hot 100 chart, was one of the most played music videos on MTV, MTV2, MTV Jams, and BET in 2003 and was embraced by the dance community, as well as the mainstream, due to a Fatboy Slim remix. 34, a third single was never released, though a video was shot for Back in the Day featuring Jay-Z and Elliott was. In between albums, Elliott produced the American Dream remix, featuring Tweet's additional vocals, of Madonna's single American Life, was featured rapper on Timbaland and Magoo's return single, Comp That Shit, and produced Fighting Temptation, featuring herself, Beyonce, Free and MC Light, for the soundtrack to the Cuba Gooding Jr. and Beyonce Knowles movie of the same name. The track reached number 1 in Japan but failed to chart in the US Hot 100. Elliott was also featured on Wyclef Jean's Party to Damascus and Ghostface Killah's Tush singles, the latter of which became a minor 2004 dance hit, and had a pivotal role in the film Honey. Gap approached Elliott later in the year to co-star in a commercial with Madonna, which received much media attention. 36, Elliott furthered her relationship with Madonna by performing the controversial 2003 MTV Video Music Awards show opening alongside Madonna, Britney Spears and Christina Aguilera. Also in September 2003, Elliott performed the theme song The Opposite Sex for the UPN sitcom Eve starring her good friend and fellow rapper Eve. It lasted for 3 seasons. A year after Elliott's most successful album to date was released, Elliott felt pressured by her label to release another album hoping to capitalize on her recent success. Elliott's singles, Past That Bitch and I'm Really Hot, from her fifth album, This Is Not a Test, released November 2003, both rose the urban charts. However, both were not as successful at pop radio in comparison to many of her previous efforts. This Is Not a Test sold 690,000 copies in the United States and has been certified platinum by the Recording Industry Association of America, RIAA. Elliott has since stated that the album This Is Not a Test came out extremely too quickly for me. I didn't want it to come out when it did. In 2004, Elliott was featured on Ciara's hit single One, Two Step, with her verse interpolating Tina Marie's single, Square Biz. Elliott premiered her own reality show on the UPN network, The Road to Stardom with Missy Elliott in 2005, even though it was not renewed for a second season. During the late 1990s and early 2000s, she sold more than 7.6 million copies in the United States, being the female rapper with best-selling albums in the country, followed by Lauryn Hill, 7 million, Lil' Kim, 4 million, and Eve, 4 million, at the time. 2005-06, The Cookbook in Respect ME. Elliott in a tracksuit with a microphone, Elliott on stage, 2006, Elliott wanted to give people the unexpected by utilizing producers other than Timbaland and a more to the center sound, not as far left as her other music. Her sixth solo album, The Cookbook, was released on July 4, 2005, debuted at number 2 on the US charts and was certified gold by the Recording Industry Association of America, RIAA, selling 645,000 copies in the United States. Elliott's work during the Cookbook era was heavily recognized. Elliott received 5 Grammy nominations in 2005, including one for Best Rap Album for the Cookbook. The album's first single, Lose Control, won a Grammy for Best Short Form Video and was nominated for Best Rap Song. Lose Control also garnered Elliott 6 2005 MTV VMA Award nominations, winning Best Dance Video and Best Hip Hop Video. Elliott won Best Female Hip Hop Artist at the 2005 American Music Awards, and was nominated for Best International Female Artist at the 2006 Brit Awards. Lose Control, featuring Ciara and Fatman Scoop, became a top 5 hit on the mid-year, peaking at number 3 on the Billboard Hot 100. The second single, Teary Eyed, did not chart, although the video charted on MTV's TRL for a few weeks, and Bet's 106 and Park for a few days. The third single, We Run This, was released with heavy airplay on VH1, MTV, and BET. It served as the lead single for the soundtrack to the gymnastics-themed film Stick It. The song was also nominated for a Grammy Award in the Best Rap Solo Performance category in 2006. Respect ME, Elliott's first greatest hits album, was released outside the United States and Canada on September 4, 2006, only in South Africa, Australia, Europe, Japan, and Brazil. The collection became her second top 10 album in the UK and her highest charting album to date, peaking at number 7 there. 2007-14, Production Work, Elliott was an honoree of the 2007 VH1 Hip Hop Honors. In honor of her career, many artists performed some of her biggest hits. Timbaland and Tui performed The Rain, Supa Dupa Fly, Eve and Keisha Cole performed Hot Boys and Work It, Fatman Scoop and Ciara performed Lose Control, and Nelly Furtado performed Get Her Freak On, the remix. Since 2007, Elliott's seventh studio album has had several different forms with extensive delays. In 2007, she worked with Timbaland, Swizz Beatz, Danja, T-Pain and DJ Toomp and planned to release an album at the beginning of 2008. In January 2008, Ching-A-Ling was released as a lead single for the Step Up to the Streets soundtrack, which also featured Shake Your Pom Pom produced by Timbaland. Elliott released the song Best in the same year and renamed the album's previous title Phenomenal to its current tentative title Block Party. She later decided against Block Party and 4 years later, in 2012, Elliott released 2 Timbaland-produced singles, Ninth Inning and Triple Threat, exclusively to iTunes. Though the songs managed to chart on Billboard Hot Digital Songs, in an interview with Yahoo's The Yo Show, Missy talked about her hiatus from making records, "Your brain needs time to refresh. Things happen in your life where you can then write something else instead of the same 3 topics. Like, how many times we gonna talk about the club? I gotta feel like what I'm giving the fans is 100% and that it's game-changing. I don't just throw out microwave records." In between the recording of her seventh album, Missy Elliott found success behind the scenes. Elliott's writing and production helped her reach number 1 on Billboard's Hot R&B Hip Hop Songs with Keisha Cole's Let It Go, 2007, Jasmine Sullivan's Need You Bad, 2008, and Monica's Everything to Me, 2010. Since 2008, songs written and or produced by Elliott for Fantasia, Free Yourself, Jennifer Hudson, I'm His Only Woman, Monica, Everything to Me, Keisha Cole, Let It Go, and Jasmine Sullivan, Need You Bad and Holding You Down, Going in Circles, have all received Grammy nominations. both Fantasia's Free Yourself, 2005, and Sullivan's Holding You Down, Going in Circles, reached number 3 on Billboard's Hot R&B Hip Hop Songs. In mid-2010, Elliott embarked on a two-part tour with stops in Europe, Asia, Africa and Australia, 48, while she also performed at VH1's Hip Hop Honors, The Dirty South in a tribute to Timbaland, performing Get Her Freak On and Work It. In 2008 she made an appearance in Hatcha Think About That by the Pussycat Dolls, and performed Live in Different Places with them. In 2011 and 2012, Elliott made guest appearances on All Night Long by Demi Lovato, Nobody's Perfect by J. Cole, the remix of Why Stop Now by Busta Rhymes with Chris Brown and Lil Wayne, and a remix of Katy Perry's Last Friday Night, TGIF that helped catapult TGIF to number 1 on the Billboard Hot 100. She also produced Monica's singles Anything, To Find You, and Until It's Gone. Throughout 2013, Missy Elliott was featured on Eve's album Cut Wannabe, as well as international artist singles, Little Mixes, How Ya Doin' and An Illyria with K-pop musician G-Dragon, which was named by Complex magazine as one of the 50 best songs of 2013 inches. Elliott also contributed to her protege Shariah J's two releases, Banji and Smash Up the Place Snatch Your Wigs. In December 2013, Elliott received a Grammy nomination with Fantasia and Kelly Rowland for their song Without Me. As early as July 2013, Missy Elliott and Timbaland held recording sessions for Kat Dahlia's debut, My Garden, 2015. In August 2013, R&B singer Faith Evans revealed that Missy Elliott would be featured on her sixth studio album, tentatively titled Incomparable. In March 2014, Evans revealed one of the tracks was named I Deserve It, featuring Missy and her protege Shariah J, in which Evans cited it as a banger and feel-good record. Evans also revealed that in total Elliott contributed 3 tracks to her album. On July 7, 2014, fellow R&B singer Monica confirmed that Elliott would be a feature on her upcoming 8th studio album. On July 29, 2014, a snippet of a Missy Elliott-produced song, Nickname I Love Him, premiered on Monica's official Instagram account. 2015-18, New Projects. In 2015, Elliott performed at the Super Bowl XLIX halftime show with Katy Perry. Elliott performed a medley of Get Her Freak On, Work It, and Lose Control. The performance was well received, and boosted digital sales of Elliott's work that week, with a 25-fold increase in album sales, to 2,000 units, and a 10-fold increase in sales of the 3 songs she performed, to 71,000 units, compared to the week before. It also became the most watched Super Bowl halftime show in NFL history, receiving 118.5 million viewers in the United States. 60. On February 3, 2015, it was confirmed that Elliott would be a feature on the upcoming remix to Diplo and Skrillex's Take You There. On February 11, Elliott stated that she was still in the process of recording her 7th studio album, Block Party, with Timbaland. On April 2, 2015, Pharrell Williams confirmed that he was working on Elliott's album during an episode of The Tonight Show with Jimmy Fallon. On November 12, 2015, WTF, Where They From, and its music video were simultaneously released to digital outlets. By November 19, the song and its video had been streamed 6.1 million times in the US alone, with an additional count of 16 million views per YouTube viewing. On February 7, 2016, the day of the 50th Super Bowl, Elliott released a promotional single, Pep Rally. Later that month, Elliott reunited with former protege Tweet and frequent collaborator Timbaland on the cut Somebody Else Will Take In from the former's 3rd studio album, Charlene. By March 15, 2016, First Lady Michelle Obama proclaimed that she had assembled a collaborative track featuring vocals from Missy Elliott, Kelly Clarkson, Janelle Monáe and Zendaya alongside production credit from pop songwriter Diane Warren and Elliott titled This Is For My Girls. The iTunes exclusive record will be used to both coincide with Ms. Obama's SXSW speech and to promote her third world educational initiative Let Girls Learn. Following a surprise appearance with TLC on the 2016 televised special Taraji's White Hot Holidays, Elliott announced plans to release a documentary chronicling her impact on the production scene in both audio and video. The midnight of January 27, 2017, saw the full-length release to a new Elliott single titled I'm Better, featuring production and vocal assistance from recurring sideman Lime and shared directing credit by Elliott and longtime colleague Dave Myers. In July 2018, Missy Elliott teased fans by appearing on a snippet nicknamed ID by Skrillex. A release date for the single has yet to be announced. 1 month later, Elliott appeared on the Ariana Grande number Borderline, taken from the singer's 4th studio album Sweetener, 2018. In October 2018, Elliott announced that she is working on her new album, which would be released in 2019. On March 20, 2019, Lizzo released a collaboration with Aaliyah titled Tempo. 2019 present, recognition and iconology. 2019 was a huge year for Elliott. On June 13, she was inducted to the Songwriters Hall of Fame, becoming the first female rapper to receive this honor. Elliott received an honorary Doctor of Music degree from Berklee College of Music, and the Michael Jackson Video Vanguard Award. She was also the first female rapper to receive the award. Elliott received the Women's Entrepreneurship Day Music Pioneer Award at the United Nations in 2019 in recognition for her achievements in music and being a leader. This award was placed in the Congressional Record. Elliott released her first extended play on August 23, 2019, titled Iconology. The five-track EP features a variety of musical genres that cover the breadth of her career as an artist and has received favorable reviews from critics. Upon release of the album, she also released the lead single, Throw It Back, with a music video featuring Teyana Taylor. Musically, Iconology is a pop, hip-hop and R&B EP reminiscent of Elliott's previous work. The opening track, Throw It Back, contains trap snares and a serpentine bass line, which along with the second track, Cool Off, were described as woozy, futuristic romps containing distorted bass lines and frenetic production. Lyrically, Throw It Back contains references to Elliott's history, as well as previous collaborators Tweet and Heavy D. Moore Johnson of Entertainment Weekly described Cool Off as calling back to hip-hop's two turntables and a mic early days. Drip Demeanor has been described as a slow jam that explores Elliott's sensuous side. Musically, it contains plush synths that skip step underneath the song's beat. Why I Still Love You is a doo-wop song with gospel influences and jazz influence that lyrically chronicles the singer's conflicted emotions about holding on to a cheating lover. The EP closes with an a cappella version of Why I Still Love You. Elliott was motivated to write uplifting music to counter mainstream trends and encourage more dance music to feel good. Drip Demeanor was released as the album's second single on October 22nd. Why I Still Love You was released as the third single on January 17, 2020. Cool Off was released as the fourth and final single from the EP on April 21, 2020. On June 26, 2020, Elliott appeared on the official remix to Toni Braxton's single Do It. Elliott co-produced the track alongside Hannon Lane. On August 13, 2020, Elliott appeared on the remix single Levitating by Dua Lipa, which also featured Madonna. The remix was produced by the blessed Madonna. Unlike Madonna, Elliott appeared in the video. The music video was directed by Will Hooper. Personal life, Elliott has said that she wants to start a family, but she is afraid of giving birth. In 2008, she stated, "I don't know if I can take that kind of pain of labor. Maybe in the year 2020 you could just pop a baby out and it'd be fine. But right now I'd rather just adopt." Elliott and her father speak occasionally, but the rapper says she has not forgiven him for the domestic violence she witnessed towards her mother. In June 2011, Elliott told People magazine that her absence from the music industry was due to a hyperthyroidism disorder known as Graves' disease. She was diagnosed after she nearly crashed a car from having severe leg spasms while driving. She experienced severe symptoms from the condition, and she could not even hold a pen to write songs. After treatment, her symptoms stabilized. Legacy: Missy Elliott's experimental concepts in her music videos changed the landscape of what a hip-hop video had as themes at the time. Her catalog of songs have included themes of feminism, gender equality, body positivity and sex positivity since the beginning of her career, being one of the first to center on these topics among hip-hop and R&B performers. The Observer's Ted Kessler stated that, with her studio albums, she has revolutionized the sound of R&B and hip-hop. Destiny's Child, Eve and Macy Gray have credited her for clearing a path in the American music industry towards their own pop preeminence as R&B hip-hop performers. An article from Vibe credits Elliott's debut Supa Dupa Fly as changing the rap game for women, noting the rapper's refusal to be pigeonholed with her image. Commercially, Missy Elliott led female hip-hop album sales during the late 1990s and early 2000s. As of 2015, she has remained the best-selling female rap album artist in the U.S. Cardi B, Lizzo, and Nicki Minaj have cited Elliott's work as an inspiration. Awards and nominations. Main article, list of awards and nominations received by Missy Elliott. Elliott has won 4 Grammy Awards, 8 MTV Video Music Awards, 2 American Music Awards, 6 BET Awards, and a Billboard Women in Music Award for Innovator. On June 13, 2019, Elliott was inducted to the Songwriters Hall of Fame, becoming the first female rapper to receive this honor. Also in 2019, Elliott received an honorary Doctor of Music degree from Berklee College of Music, and the Michael Jackson Video Vanguard Award. She was also the first female rapper to receive the award. Elliott received the Women's Entrepreneurship Day Music Pioneer Award at the United Nations in 2019 in recognition for her achievements in music and being a leader. This award was placed in the Congressional Record. Other ventures, biographical film. In 2005, there were plans to make a biographical film about the life story of Elliott. It was to be co-produced by Robert De Niro and Jane Rosenthal, and written by Diane Houston. In mid-June 2007, Elliott said she was still working on the script with Houston in order to come up with the right stuff, cause I don't want it to be watered down. I want it to be raw and uncut the way my life was. Initially, it seemed Timbaland wouldn't be a part of the movie. When Missy asked him, he refused, citing he felt it dramatized his character. The movie is about her life, her story, that goes deeper than putting me into the movie. Philanthropy. In 2002, Elliott wrote a letter on behalf of PETA to the mayor of her hometown Portsmouth, Virginia, asking that all shelter animals be neutered spayed before being adopted. For the reality TV show The Road to Stardom, there was a contest for viewers to create a public service ad for the Break the Cycle Fund. In 2004, she joined forces with MAC Cosmetics to promote their Viva Glam campaign. In addition to the ad campaign, Elliott promoted the MAC Viva Glam V lipstick, from which 100% of the sale goes to the MAC AIDS Fund. In 2007, Elliott appeared on an ABC's Extreme Makeover and awarded 4 scholarships for a weight loss program to 4 underprivileged teens. In August 2017, a 27-year-old Virginia man named Nathan Coughlin began a Change.org petition that gained over 30,000 signatures in support of a statue to honor Elliott's philanthropic endeavors to be erected in her hometown of Portsmouth, Virginia. On the petition's proposed site for the statue currently stands a Confederate monument, which led to widespread media coverage in several national publications including The Washington Post, Huffington Post, Newsweek, and Time magazine.